Vlogmas Day 16. Today's prompt is if you make Christmas decorations, show us some. If you don't, tell us an idea you have for Christmas decorations. Honestly, if I had a Christmas tree put up someplace, which I never do, I used to have a little 2-foot one and it died. It broke and it was unrepairable. So it went in the garbage and I never replaced it because when I got that one, it was really kind of cheap. And afterward, they were really kind of expensive, so I never replaced it. Anywho, would be nice to have a full-size tree and actually have room for a full-size tree. But anyways, full-size tree and a bunch of pushing ornaments off of the on the tree there. Pushing the cat ornaments all over the thing. That would be the perfect Christmas tree, you betcha. Yeah. Sitting here waiting for a delivery. It's the rest of my Christmas food goodies. I've ordered my pickles and stuff like that. I got into the pickles that I had, so I had to order more. And I expanded the pickle selection, so there's going to be more pickles than ever. It's a thing we used to always do. We also always had a whack load of pickles at Christmas, a whole bunch of different kinds. I've got dill chips, the pickle chips, dill pickle chips, pickled beets, garlic stuffed olives, and pickled onions. That's the pickle selection that I'm going to be having. And, of course, some cheese, some medium cheddar, because I couldn't find old cheddar that wasn't a giant block the size of my head for $20. So $30. They wanted $30 for that thing, but it was an enormous amount of cheese. I'm not going to eat that much cheese. So I just got a little block, and I couldn't get the old one, just the medium one. So, yeah. It'll be Cracker Barrel cheese unless they substitute. And that's usually what we got at Christmas was Cracker Barrel. We used to get nuts all the time and candy, but I'm not doing that because nuts and candy are insane for price. A little container of candy is just Christmas candy is outrageous. I do remember. They were on sale after Christmas at the co-op and trays of Christmas candy, right? And I got one for half price, and which was a normal price for candy. The ribbon candy was all one piece. They were all stuck together. They were in little pie-shaped wedges, pie piece-shaped wedges, right? And I picked it up and went up and they all came out in one piece. It was just like so many ribbon candies before them. So I'm just sitting here watching the security camera for my delivery, which is going to be probably another hour. I keep ordering from them in the morning, and they never get their 2-hour window thing that they say within 2 hours. It's never within 2 hours from the people that do the Superstore delivery. Is a they don't deliver here. They get another company to do it. They just do the personal shopping, and the guy comes and gets it and delivers it to your place for a small fortune. But it's better than going there. So, you know, it's $7.99 for delivery right now. They started at $2.99, and then it went up to $9.99. Now it's been $7.99 the last 3 times I've had delivery. So, yeah. And on the 19th, which is Saturday, I'm getting a free Christmas dinner delivered to my door. Everybody in the building's getting one. The Tenants Association has catered it from Carol's Catering here in town, and they do some pretty good work, so some pretty good stuff. At least they did. Last time I was out there, they screwed up spaghetti, and I don't know how they messed up spaghetti, but I wasn't too impressed, but it's free, so, you know, yippers. So we'll be getting the Christmas dinner sometime between 3:30 and 5 p.m. Delivered to our door, so, yeah, I'll have to be watching out for that. Yippers, I am waiting for my stuff before I do my coffee because I don't want to be grinding it and miss the buzzer or anything, so... Yeah, it's a loud machine. The machine is loud. Woo! Yep. I'd probably hear it, but yeah. Anyways, just to just keep the counter clear while I'm waiting for the order. So yeah. I remember the one time I won a turkey. There was the radio station had a contest on for a 30-pound turkey, and I won this 30-pound turkey, and I had this tiny apartment-sized stove. This was when I was living on South Hill, and there's this tiny stove, and I couldn't physically get it into the oven, so it wouldn't fit, right? Plus, I'm not a huge fan of turkey. It gives me a headache. It just does. And yeah, I'll have a headache after my turkey dinner on Saturday. But yeah, I'm going to be grateful for it anyways. So you betcha. Yeah, anyways, that's it. That's all. You have a fabulous day and keep smiling.